My name is Tony Griswold. I'm an associate scientist here at the John P. Hussman Institute for Human Genomics. So right now I manage our bioinformatics analysis team and our statistical consulting core. So I've been interested in the underlying genetics for autism. So autism is a very prevalent disorder. About 1 in 60 kids right now is being diagnosed. And we don't have a good understanding of what genes and mutations are underlying that disorder. I like the puzzle-solving aspect of doing science in general. I think that to be able to ask complicated questions and then to arrive at an answer is a rewarding type of thing. I never quite know what to expect when I come in every day. I like the people who work here. I'm very passionate about understanding autism and helping families understand autism. The questions themselves and then the teamwork of working towards the answers are really probably my two favorite things. I was born in Miami, Florida. You know, in school, I had always had a, you know, proclivity towards math and sciences, and it was what I was good at, logical thinking and problem solving. And so, you know, as a youngster, you know, from a teenager, I think I realized that that was the type of career I wanted to go into, and whether that was going to be as a physician or as a researcher or an engineer, you know, those things sort of fleshed them out over time. But it's something that I've always had an interest in. My motivation for going into science was actually from a movie that I saw, which, depending on who's watching this, may or may not remember this movie, but it was a Dustin Hoffman movie called Outbreak, and I think I was probably a teenager, and it was, you know, a bunch of researchers trying to hunt down a virus in the jungle in Africa, and, you know, in the big bubble suits and walking around, and I remember thinking, like, wow, these guys, this is a really cool job, you know, to be hunting down, you know, this virus. I didn't know what a virus was when I was 13. When the Human Genome Project came out in 2001, it had taken about 20 years and it cost, you know, $100 billion to sequence the first human genome. And today we can sequence a genome in about a week for about $1,000. And so I think that that's really just fascinating how we've, in the course of 15 years, we've, you know, decreased the cost, we've increased output. Whatever level you think you're at, there's still another level to come. And that's, I think, what's the most exciting. On a personal level, I want to understand the things that I work on. And I think the global research community, you know, combining all of our efforts, I think will really answer the big questions. But personally, I think that it's answering the small questions that's really my goal. If you have interest in math and you have interest in science and what do they call these STEM careers now, right? If you are a problem-solving person and a puzzle-solving person and you have a curious mind to know either how the body works or how the cell works or how do things less than a cell work, if you're asking yourself those questions now, I can just imagine what will exist for you 10 years from now when you're ready to start a career like this. So stick with it, go for it, don't be dissuaded, and do your best. We'll be right back.